Good morning, Ava. What do you got there? Your socks? Good morning. You took off your socks and you're waving them around there. Oh, okay. You're watching the backyard again. You like that song you sing in there? You're showing Roxy your socks. Well, good morning. It's Sunday, and we're all up now. Getting started. Yes, I will make you breakfast in a little while. Wave from over there. Good morning.
Good morning.
Making breakfast for Chris and I. Some eggs with spinach and cheese. So I'm just kind of getting the spinach to break apart and go down there, whatever it's called, and we got some eggs and some white cheddar. And Ava's getting antsy.
Ava, you look like such a big girl in your little high chair eating your little puffs, your strawberry puffs. You're not a little tiny preemie anymore. You look very cute in your happy little pink and blue outfit today.
With your gluten-free strawberry treat.
Yes, gluten-free organic superfood strawberry treat. I mean, they're not the best thing ever, but the reason why I really resisted, I think I showed you guys on the vlog the other day, I really resisted giving her these. Because I didn't want her to have any grains at all. But I've decided that a little rice once in a while and some oats once in a while is okay. But I really want her to not eat grains as much as possible because I really believe they cause inflammation. But these guys, it's like 25 of them, it's like 75 calories. They're mostly air and they're really like to teach the kids about different texture. And let them melt in their mouth. I don't know.
Are you tired?
Hi guys. So it's like 4:00 in the afternoon, and I just realized I haven't vlogged all day, like face to face vlogging. It's been another slow day for me. I was basically in bed all day or on the recliner. So I kind of decided yesterday. But definitely decided today I'm going to go get a blood transfusion tomorrow because I don't want to spend basically another week feeling this bad. And also my chemo is on Thursday. And while I could get a blood transfusion and get chemo at the same time, it would probably be better if my blood counts were up before that chemo. So they can knock me down again. But the only drawback with getting it now is it takes about 2 to 3 days to feel better, and by the time I feel better I have to go get chemo, but it will probably help the chemo not be so toxic and not be so exhausting. I mean, can you guys believe it's already time for me to go back in and get the carbo Gemzar toxic combo? I'm always surprised at like, oh, it's already time to go back in for the super toxic chemo. I also see my actual oncologist this week, and she'll probably be ordering a scan. So we're going to find out how the chemo's doing. I have been having some random pains that seem to coincide with the cancer growing or spreading, but honestly, I've had these pains before and gotten reports back that the cancer was stable. So like all cancer patients, I start speculating and getting stress like before the scan. It's just like scan anxiety. I don't know. It's just something you do. And you shouldn't do it because You don't know what's on the scan until the scan comes back. But anyways, so yeah, I'm gonna go get a blood transfusion. This is just ridiculous. And probably next time I'm not gonna wait like how I did last week. I was just so like, I'm not gonna go in the hospital on my week off. But it didn't really do me any good. It just made me feel worse. And yeah, I didn't have to go to the hospital, but I just felt yucky all week. So I probably should have gone as soon as I realized how sick I was feeling. So I just text messaged Alyssa and let her know that we're probably going to be leaving as soon as she gets here at 9, because I got to call the breast center and tell them I'm coming in. So yeah, and also I've realized I need to clean up my weekend eating. Like every weekend, me and Ernie both gain weight, and it doesn't feel like we're eating that much more, but somehow we are. So I don't know if it's like just not the well, the Cuban food just it's not very healthy. Cuban food's awesome, but it's not healthy. And the enchilada thing I made last night, that was pretty. That wasn't too bad because I literally had like one little tiny square like this much, and then I gave some of it to Ernie because I actually wasn't that hungry. But I am noticing on the days I don't eat my steel cut oats, I gain weight the next day. I don't know if those steel cut oats have some magical weight loss thing, but every day that I eat them, I lose a little bit of weight. It's crazy. So, also, I need to get back on my super anti-cancer diet. There's several different versions of that diet. But I need to get back on that diet because I was actually feeling a lot better. I don't know if it necessarily helps my actual cancer, but it helps me to feel better overall. So that'll be a goal for next week. Right now, I just got to get through today and then go get my blood transfusion tomorrow, which will probably be a little bit on the exhausting side. And then get through this next 3 weeks again. I mean, here we go. This is how somebody with metastatic cancer, this is how you live your life in these chemo cycles. Everyone's chemo cycle is a little bit different. Mine's a 3 week cycle right now. I don't even remember what my cycle was with Halavin last year, but whatever that was. And you just live your life in these cycles, inside these chemotherapy cycles.
The one where there's the cowboy and he's like the king of the
Is castle. that your teapot,
And
Ava?
this
And you're having
hospital
some
shows
tea?
up and he
You're
tries to
so
get over.
cute.
And so the cowboy tries to murder him, but instead,
You're pouring your
this man
tea?
is taken hostage by
Look
like
at you,
this evil
cutie.
psychopath. And the cowboy has to rescue him. And then they end up becoming really good friends.
Dustin?
Oh my god, that's the
Oh,
story.
Ava, I
That's it.
love
That's
you.
it. I love that movie. Oh.
You got one fucked up perspective on the world, too.
Yeah, I do, and this is why I'm gonna be locked up.
You know how to use a cup already.
That's what makes you great.
Ava Cam, did you have a nice Sunday, little Miss Ava? Seems like you had a pretty good Sunday.
Hello, YouTube. So I am out and about with Ava. You can see her foot up right there, and her little hand reaching towards her foot. Just running a couple quick errands. Chris is resting. And considering going tomorrow to get a blood transfusion, and so we'll see how she feels. I think she should. She's just worried about me taking time off of work, and I said that I told her I should worry about that. That I'm more concerned about her. We should worry about how she's feeling. She's been feeling awful for over a week, so hopefully she'll make the right choice. And I get it. It'll mean that she goes to the hospital twice in 1 week. But if it also means she'll feel a little better and her blood counts go up, it's also you know, safer. That's, you know, so you can't tell her what to do. She has to make that choice. But hi, honey. I see you back there being a good girl. Normally, your mom's with us and you have company in the back seat with you, but that's okay. She was watching some movie from Israel, I think. I don't know what it was when we left. So hopefully she's relaxing and enjoying the day as much as possible.
Avery. Ava, it's playtime with Daddy, huh? And Mommy. Mommy's here too. She is so good at maneuvering this now. It's really amazing, isn't it, Ernie? Like, literally, before we started the vlog, this was not happening.
Yeah, I know.
And she's moving. She's crawling faster, too. Remember when we were at James's birthday and he was, like, crawling like a speed demon?
Yeah.
And I was thinking, oh, Ava crawls so slow.
Now
she but now she crawls similar to James's pace.
Yeah.
You gonna destroy everything Mommy just put away?
For some reason, she likes to climb on top of that zoo. And
yeah.
Sit on it.
Yeah. You have your preferences, don't you? Yeah. Daddy's got those cool blocks. We should really show her how to use them. That was one of the milestones Tristan wanted, was her stacking blocks. Which she's done. I haven't been playing with her very much with him. You gonna go stack blocks with Daddy?
Look, Ava.
Nope. No, I'm not. I'm gonna go do what I want to do. Because I'm 1 year old, and that's how I roll. You gonna try to get under there? I think you're actually too big to get under there now. There was a time when you could have got under there.
Yeah. Oh, you found one of your coins.
Your Auntie Ricky got you that toy for Christmas. And this whole set up here, my mom got her at the Stapleton garage sales. If you're from Colorado, you know about those. That's Mommy's favorite. Ernie's playing with the Princess Castle because it's so cool. You have to admit it's cool, right, Ernie?
Bing! Yeah.
Admit it. What t-shirt did you have on yesterday? That one?
At some point, I wore it yesterday evening.
Oh, because someone commented about your t-shirt and I was trying to think which one it was. I guess it's that one.
Yeah. I had
Ernie has a tendency of
laundry.
Right, but you wear like 5 t-shirts in a day. Like, I don't know. This man changes out t-shirts. It's crazy. 5 t-shirts in a day.
Not 5.
I've seen you do 5 in a day. I'm just saying it's happened. That's all I'm saying.
Ava.
This is how you keep a marriage together, Ava. You let your husband wear 5 t-shirts in a day if he wants to. How about we don't knock over the air purifier, Ava? That'd be good.
Even if it was
true,
she
understands.
I was going to do the laundry, so.
It's okay. You can wear, I'm just saying, you do wear a lot of t-shirts.
Switch them out. This one has to be washed after in the shower.
Well, hi, but wow. I know you guys keep hearing me say wow on these vlogs, but I really am amazed at everything she does every day. Ava Cam. What are you doing? Oh, you're getting into the missing sock bag. Peter Rabbit's missing sock bag.
Oh.
missing sock. Really, Ava? You're gonna get all the socks out?
Probably. Sorting time.
That's okay, she likes to sort. Looks like your Peter Rabbit stuffed animals in there, from what I just saw. Nope, not a match.
Why is there a rabbit in there?
It's that rabbit your mom sent her. What's in there, Ava? Oh, you're gonna put them all back? That's very nice. Are you gonna put them back? You're gonna put those babies back? What are you doing? You gonna put those missing socks back in the missing socks bag? Nope, nope, you're gonna crawl walk. Here she goes crawl walking. This is her new thing. Maybe other babies do this. I've never seen one do it. I've only had two babies. I don't remember Alyssa doing it.
It's like a dance thing on her.
It's like you're dancing, Ava.
You breaking?
Yellow. Green. Purple. You want to do it again? Good job. Who's got the ball? You gonna kiss the ball? Ava's got the ball. Now me and Ernie are playing ball.
All questions, the Pope's dogs.
It all came to an abrupt end last August.
Snuggle buggle time. Ernie used the panini maker for the first time, and we're having grilled cheese and tomato soup, which is very reminiscent of my childhood. Did your mom used to make you this?
No.
Oh, this is my childhood. Anyways, thanks, honey.
You're welcome.
Ava, did Daddy put your jam jams on? Let's see these jammies that Daddy put on.
Supergirl.
It's Supergirl pajamas. Yeah, but her lovey's covering up. Supergirl pajamas. You know Daddy likes that. Are you a Superman fan?
Well, when I was a kid, yeah, sure.
But nothing beats the original Superman to me. Well, my original Superman from the 80s. Which I guess
it's not the original.
I know, but with
Christopher Reeve.
With Christopher, yes.
Yes.
To me, that's the original Superman, but I'm just an 80s kid, that's why. We are watching Rising Star right now. It's so cool. Like, you download the app, and then it lets you vote, like, right away. To raise the wall or whatever. But in like interacting with this show, I'm realizing like this is the future of entertainment, like interactive entertainment with apps and voting and pretty cool. So yeah. All right, guys. Bye bye.